venu si nombreux ce soir pour le concert de Odaya et Arsar sur le 7e feu.
Thank you so much for coming tonight for the concert of Regal sur le 7e feu and Odaya.
Alors, sans plus attendre, on va accueillir Odaya sur la scène.
And first, we'll hear a performance from Odaya.
Un jeûne traditionnel de 4 jours dans le nord de l'Ontario, près du lac Supérieur. Pendant mon jeûne, dans un moment où j'étais en recueillement, c'est un chant qui est venu à moi, que j'ai entendu, puis que j'ai répété. Et c'est la première fois ce soir qu'on l'interprète dans un show, dans un concert. Donc, on pensait que c'était en fait très approprié parce que le regard sur le septième feu, ben, ça parle hein, des enseignements, de l'importance de se connecter à nos traditions, à notre culture, de se connecter à la terre, au lien qu'on a avec notre mère, la terre, pour rester fort, puis la protéger. Donc, en participant à nos cérémonies, on contribue à maintenir ce lien-là, puis respecter la terre.
I go to you with the feel of a quiet home, bound in the yellow grounds of the castle I remove. When dreams fade, I wait to catch your conscience. Stand in the camp where I was born to bring you a cup of tea and a feeling. I wait to do the right thing by the small flowers and the fauna and the flora and the flesh. And patiently, gently touch with your red fireweed fingers. And which makes its way into our itzy. And later I will think back to Godon's itzy. As it gives its final dance in the silence of trees and the gentle bite of autumn breeze. I wait for your fingers as they glint red in the smoke and morning light. I watch beautiful labor move in perfect rhythm with yesterday's songs. Mm-hmm. the knowledge of grandmothers. We stand bathed in smoke all day long, thinking about plant beings and animal spirits to feed those who come after. And I wait for you to smile up at me. I wait for your hands on my hands. I wait for knowledge. When dreams fade.
We actually just composed this this week, and Samantha's poem. So it basically came out of a kitchen table conversation rehearsal where we were talking about the new study that was made in Abitibi-Témiscamingue by the Quebec Wildlife Association, I think, and Abitibi-Témiscamingue Health Department. And they actually analyzed the liver and the kidneys, the organs of the mooses up there, of more than 30 mooses. And it showed that it was toxic. All the livers of all the animals and the kidneys were not fit to eat anymore. And our animals, it's part of our way of life, and it's what we eat. And the liver and the kidneys are actually very, very much praised, and it's a delicacy, especially for elders. It's a medicine for us to be eating moose. So with everything that's happening with the polluting and the contamination and the animals now eating mercury and plastic, then we will get sick as well if we continue eating them. And Naka's grandmother had just sent some dried, was it moose or caribou?
It was dried moose.
Yeah, it was moose. So we were talking about that maybe one day, and it's actually part of the prophecies too, that epidemics will come out of the fish and the animals that we will eat. So that's what this piece is dedicated to. And on va juste continuer avec une berceuse qui est en fait du peuple de Anik, le peuple Wendat. So it's a Wendat lullaby.
Thank you.
say the drum is the heartbeat of the earth, and our hearts are also a heartbeat and a drum. So if you want to join me and beat to the heartbeat of the earth, please do.
That's the one.
Neki, 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 neki,
Huron Wendat on my father's side. My mom is French from Ontario, and my band is Picogan in Abitibi. It's an Anishinaabe Algonquin community.
I'm Emily Monet, and my mother is from Kitigan-Zibi, so I'm Anishinaabe, and my dad is French, so I'm also French.
My name is Naka, and I'm from the Northwest Territories. My dad is Dene.
My mother's Quebecer. Yeah, but it's been a few years that we've been singing, but it started really because we wanted to create a community of, to be as Native women in the city and being disconnected from the communities our families are from, and so we wanted to create a sense of community and get closer to our culture through the drum. And so we were fortunate to be receiving songs throughout the years, and to be to be learning how to sing and to assert our voices as Indigenous women. So yeah.
So we became a non-profit organization since 2008, and the profit that we raise, we give them back to the community creating projects. For example, we organize the Christmas feasts every year for, it's going to be the fifth year this year, for a native shelter, which is called PAC, Projet Autochtone du Québec.
For homelessness.
Exactly, for homeless Aboriginal people. And we also support different projects or organizations that we believe in. So this is our vision. We all carry the same values of compassion and offering and cultural strength and pride of identity. And for us, doing that made a lot of sense. It's our purpose. It's our strength.
Thank you. So the next and final song from us is a healing song, and it kind of fits within the theme of tonight, and so we are offering this healing song to Mother Earth, to uplift her and to give her strength. She needs it right now, so thank you.
Why Yahweh, oh, hey, why Yahweh, oh.